My book, Amazing Dog Training Man. This is my dog, Martini. One of the things I write about in my book, The Amazing Dog Training Man, is the reverse dog training method. I came up with the reverse dog training method to help dog owners understand the training process, to understand behavior, and most importantly, to understand their dogs. So each one of the letters, R-E-V-E-R-S-E, stands for something. So the first R is for responsibility. Then it is easy. And then V is for viewpoint. So it's responsibility. You take responsibility for training. It should be easy. It should be easy and fun to train your dog. And then viewpoint. V is for viewpoint. And that means looking at everything you do with your dog through your dog's viewpoint. Think about everything you do from your dog's point of view. And when you do that, it will really change the way you look at dog training. Because a lot of the information out there on dog training is very harsh. Some of it's cruel. Some of it is outright illegal. You know, the dog is really suffering. I've seen some terrible, terrible, terrible things done to dogs in the 20 plus years that I've been working with them. I've seen some terrible trainers and just awful. I can tell you a horror story on top of horror story. So what I did a long time ago is I really started thinking about it. Because some dog trainers will say, here, put this collar on your dog, some kind of awful collar, and they'll say, start yanking the dog all over the place. And then you're sitting there and you're going, geez, this doesn't seem right. I feel bad for the dog. No, this is the way it's done. Use the collar. Don't be a pansy. Get out there and start working with the dog. And so what I always try to do is I always try to look at it from my dog's point of view. If I was the dog, would this be enjoyable? Because the training process really should be enjoyable for you and the dog. Of course, there's things that are going to happen in the training process that your dog's not going to like. And it's not that I'm against punishment. You know, there's a lot of trainers out there, never punish your dog. But that's not me. Sometimes punishment does have its role in training. But for the most part, we want to try to strengthen the bond with our dog through our training. So if you were doing something to your dog and it seemed like it was harming the dog, look at it from your dog's point of view. Common way to train a dog to walk on leash is to put a choke chain on them, and then if they move a few feet in front of us, to snap it and then release. If they move that way, to snap it and release. If they start to pull, snap it and release. But what happens is that the dog is on this choke chain, they're right next to us, and every time they start to do anything, we give them a correction. So imagine it from your point of view. Say you were walking down the street next to somebody. Say there's a guy next to me. And every time I just took a little step forward, bang, he punched me in the arm. Sorry, Teeny. Bang, he punched me in the arm. I started to step a little bit that way. Boom, he hit me again. If I started to step back, boom, he kept punching me. Imagine this guy punching me as we're walking down the street. It's kind of what we're doing to a dog when he's on choke collar. We're constantly punching him. Hey, stop that. Boom, boom, boom. We keep nailing the dog. So, again, if you were walking next to somebody and kept punching you, would you want to walk next to that person? No. Here's what would happen. First thing that may happen, depending on your personality, is you may turn around and nail that guy. If you have a different type of personality, first chance you get, you're going to run like hell. So think about your dog next to you. Boom, you punch him. And then eventually you want to start doing off-leash work. You unclip the leash. What's the dog going to do? Hey, I'm out of here. Takes off. Or dog might start to become aggressive. Maybe not towards you, but maybe towards other dogs. So look at everything through your dog's point of view. It will help you become a better trainer. And when you use the reverse method, you'll learn these techniques that will help you become a trainer, better trainer, and your training will be much more effective. You'll get better results. If you go to my website, AmazingDogTrainingBook.com, I give away the first four chapters of my book. And in chapter two, I explain the reverse method front to back. You can learn all about it. So go. Check out the first four chapters, learn more about the reverse method, and see if it doesn't help you. Thanks for watching this video. Good luck training your dog.